Sport School is brought to you by BASF and Pride Seeds.
So it's about the third week of June, getting towards the end of the month. This was late April planted corn. It's going to be tasseling probably sometimes around July 10th, July 15th. So the nitrogen's on, the weeds are controlled. The next thing we're going to be thinking about is plant health, looking at, in particular, the fungicide applications at the tassel stage. And so as you can see in this field, we've got a lot of variability, and that's been the story this spring. Lots of variability everywhere due to weather and frost events, and some of the corn on corn in particular has been problematic. So when it comes to staging a crop for fungicide, you can see right off the bat, some of these low areas are going to tassel perhaps a week or two behind. So you have to get an idea, well, what percentage of the field is really bad, and what am I going to focus on? Well, you're going to focus on the good corn and maybe sacrifice some of this lower ground by maybe applying a little earlier, so you save the majority of the crop. And we have technology like drones to can measure the area that's like this. And boy, when you stand in an area like this, you really get the idea that everything's bad, and it's not necessarily bad. This could only be 2 acres out of 50 that's really bad, and you need to get that perspective. But certainly the timing of fungicide, and then we start worrying about Western bean cutworm, and it's a very fussy egg layer, so it's looking for the tassel and pollen to be at the right stage. So the rest of the field may not be impacted, but something like this is going to tassel 2 weeks later. This could be an ideal egg laying site for Western bean cutworm, and if you miss that opportunity of scouting and doing appropriate integrated pest management and deciding whether or not you've breached the threshold in this area, then it becomes problematic. Well, how are you going to address it in this area? And we know that Western bean cutworm can certainly be a vector for things like vomitoxin and dawn and corn. So it's going to be some challenges this year to understand just how we're going to go about protecting plant health and looking at all the things we need to capture the yield that we're all looking for. So in this field, there's far more of this than there is of the other. So this is what we want to focus on for the staging of fungicide and do our scouting for Western bean cutworm when after the peak moth flight has occurred. And this is really where the high yield potential is. And so getting a perspective on the field as to how you're going to manage, when you're going to manage the field. So these are the areas you need to focus on. And like I said, it might only be 1 or 2% of the field that's really impacted. And you can decide whether you want to manage that later or not. We have lots of variable rate technology to come back and touch these areas up after the fact. I know it's another trip through the field. But when it comes to protecting plant health, if you invested in the seed and the herbicide and the fertilizer, you want to maximize that and be ashamed to let this crop get diseased and lose its potential for yield because the photosynthetic factory is shut down and it can't fill the cob, and then you got stock quality issues and standability and harvest issues. So we really need to be focused on protecting this crop and managing it all the way through the season. Uneven fields tend to have a long tail on them, so let's manage this crop right through to the end of the season.